Alhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah wa ala ali wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. Fa'uz billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Ya ayyatuha an-nafsul mutmainna irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan marziya. Fadkhuli fi ibadi wadkhuli jannati. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. My respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy, and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is 17 causes that bring happiness. That which brings happiness in this world, in this transient life, though the real happiness, the everlasting one, the happiness which is free from all worries, anxieties, troubles, is only in Jannah. But in this world also, we can live happily if we follow the commandments and the instructions of our Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the nature of man to look for happiness. Everyone is looking for happiness. Some people tread on the right path and they've found this happiness, while others, they've gone the wrong way, the evil path, and they're still looking for it, but they haven't found it yet. Some people look for happiness in drugs, money, prestige, and other types of sinfulness, but yet they do not attain happiness. As you know, my dear brothers and sisters, that a human being consists of two parts, the body and the soul. And unless and until you strike a balance between the body and the soul, you will not find happiness. Yes, you're trying to satisfy the needs of the flesh, but by only focusing on the flesh, you will not find happiness. Don't you see people killing themselves though they have all kinds of freedom? They're free to do anything. Drugs, women, alcohol, anything. No limitations at all. But yet, they're worried. Yet, they're in misery. Why? If happiness is money, why are rich people killing themselves and committing suicides? Now, having mentioned these, my dear brothers and sisters, I would like to start mentioning the 17 causes that will, inshallah, by the grace of Allah Azza wa Jal, bring happiness into our lives. The first cause is the shukr and fikr. Think and thank. Think who brought you into life. Why am I here? What does Allah want from me? What am I doing? Where am I going? And when am I going? Because every human being knows he's leaving this world sooner or later. Do you know the answer of all these questions? Puzzling questions. So the first cause is the fikr, to think and to obey, to worship the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Holy Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 152, فَاسْكُرُونِ يَاسْكُرْكُمْ وَاسْكُرُونِ وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. And remember me, and I will remember you. And be grateful to me for the favors I bestow upon you, and do not be ungrateful to me. I would like to narrate to you an incident of a student of Hadith, Imam Ibrahim Rahmatullah Alayh, and his brother. They were traveling for the cause of Hadith when they reached the river bank. They decided to rest and open the bags for food. What was the food? Dry breads. They started dipping the breads into the water and ate it. Imam Ibrahim Rahmatullah Alayh said, by Allah, had the sons of the kings felt how we feel, they would have surely fought us with their swords. Allahu Akbar. What they have to eat with themselves is dry breads and water. But he was talking about the real happiness, which is inside ourselves. Happiness, according to Shaykh al-Islam, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi, what he said about was, what can my enemies do to me? My Jannah is in my chest. My imprisonment is privacy with Allah. My deportation is trifling in the land of Allah. A person has reached this level. What can you do for him? What can you do? This is the real happiness. So that is the first cause, my dear brothers and sisters. The fikr, to think and to obey, to thank the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cause number two is, what has happened in the past has happened. No need to regret. If any calamity strikes, we say, قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ وَمَا شَاءَ فَعَلَ. Allah so decreed and He does what He wills. Imam Ibn Qayyim rahmatullah alayhi asked, which is faster, the rabbit or the dog? The people replied, the rabbit. Imam Ibn Qayyim rahmatullah alayhi said, but yet the dog catches up with the rabbit. The dog is slower, the rabbit is faster, but yet the dog catches up with the rabbit. The people had no answer. Then the Shaykh continued, because the stupid rabbit runs, stops, and looks back. We should not be like the rabbit. What has happened in the past has happened and should not affect our presence of happiness. Cause number three is, live your day to the fullest. Today, I will not think about tomorrow. Enjoy your day. For instance, you're sitting with your family, your kids are around you, your wife is sitting next to you. It's a beautiful atmosphere, a cozy atmosphere. But you can easily spoil this beautiful feeling by remembering the bad memories, the bad days. Is this sanity? You are having a good time and you're spoiling it by remembering the bad memories? No, my dear brothers and sisters, we should always enjoy our presence of happiness. That is cause number three, to live your day to the fullest. Cause number four is, leave tomorrow till tomorrow. Our Salaf, the pious predecessors, understood this very well. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu used to work for a Jew and used to draw water for him from work. For one day's work, he used to attain a handful of dates. He would say, this is a risk for today. This is a sustenance for today. Tomorrow, Allah will provide. Allahu Akbar. Many of us, my dear brothers and sisters, have real estate, have money in the banks, and have many other things. But yet, we are worried. The mother, the wife is carrying a whiplash in the husband, saying, do something for your kid's future. She's after you till you collapse in ICU. When Umar bin Abdulaziz rahmatullah alayhi was dying, he said to his sons, my sons, I'd not leave a single penny for you. I'd not leave anything for you to commit sin on. If you're righteous, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. He did not leave anything for his children. And also, the righteousness of the father means Allah's protection over the children. But the main thing is taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you read, Surah Kahf, chapter number 18, verse number 82. وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارُ فَكَانَ لِغُلَامَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ And as for the wall, it belonged to two orphan boys in the town. وَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا And there lay underneath it treasure which belonged to them. وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا And their father was a righteous man. فَأَرَادَ رَبُّكَ أَنْ يَبْلُغَا شُدَّهُمَا And your Lord intended that they attain their age of full strength. وَيَسْتَخْرِجَا كَنْزَهُمَا And take out the treasure, رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ As a mercy from your Lord. So that is cause number four, to leave tomorrow till tomorrow. Cause number five is to meet and face the unfair criticism bravely. Meet the unfair criticism bravely, my dear brothers and sisters. Because people will criticize us. People will insult us. People will say bad things about us. By Allah, they were fools that they criticized the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are not better than the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, if the fools say something, just ignore it. I would like to narrate a story of a legendary character in the Arabic literature named as Yuha. Some people say it was actuated and not legendary. Once Yuha said to his son, my son, do not concentrate and focus on what the people say about you because they will always say bad things about you, even if you have done them no harm. And today, I will prove it to you. The son agreed. The son, Yuha, and his donkey set out together. They passed a first group of people. The people said, look at these people, they're fools, they're having a donkey but no one's riding it. Yuha said to his son, count this as number one. And then Yuha instructed his son to ride the donkey. And they passed a second group of people. The people said, look at this son, he has no adab, he has no manners. His father, the poor old man, is walking while he's riding the donkey. Yuha told to his son, count this as number two. And then Yuha asked his son to get down and he rode the donkey. What did the people say? The people said, look at this father. He has no rahmah. He has no mercy for his child. He's riding a donkey while his child is walking. Yuha told his son, count this as number three. And then Yuha and his son both ride the donkey. The people said, look at these people. They have no rahmah. They have no mercy. They are riding a donkey and he's carrying a burden of two. Yuha told his son, count this as number four. And then Yuha and his son both decide to carry the donkey. But did the people leave them? No. The people said, look at these crazy people. They're fools. Instead of the donkey carrying them, they are carrying the donkey. So, we should not focus and concentrate on what the people say, because people will eat away at times. Verily, you will not be able to silence them, but you will be able to bury their criticism by dismissing what they have to say. Allah says in the Holy Quran, in Surah Al Imran, Chapter 3, Verse 119, "Kul mutu bi ghayzikum," say, perish in a rage. So, that is cause number 5, to meet and to face the unfair criticism bravely.
Fresh to holy peace.
Images, and depictions of our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have spread around the globe.
May endless blessings be upon thee.
His life is being examined in the glare of the global media spotlight. It is the duty of every Muslim to present to the world the truth of his life and the excellence of his character.
And we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a mercy to the universe.
To do this, you have to know your prophet. It's something that you simply can't afford to be ignorant of.
Send your peace on your slave Muhammad.
Study the exemplary personality of our Prophet, peace be upon him, which attracts people of all faiths and nationalities in Know Your Prophet, peace be upon him. Every Tuesday at 8 p.m. and repeat telecast at 8:30 a.m. India on Peace TV.
A friendly message by Dr. Zakir. The last testament of God.
It is a proclamation to humanity. A fountain of mercy and wisdom. A guide to the erring. A warning to the heedless. An assurance to those in doubt. A solace to the suffering. A hope to those in despair. Al-Quran, the most positive book in the world. The final message of God to humanity. Let's read it. Understand it and follow it.
Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Fresh to holy peace.
Cause number 6 is expect not appreciation from people. Expect not appreciation from people, my dear brothers and sisters. Shaykh al-Islam, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi said, you will not reach the true station, the true ikhlas, until the ones who despise you and praise you be the same for you. What does this mean? It means that if someone praises me, I feel good. MashaAllah, superb, jazakallah. But at this moment, there's no room for improvement. And on the other hand, if someone despises me, I try to defend myself and I get hurt inside. But the true mukhlis is the person whom you despise or praise. It's the same for him and that's it. Do not expect appreciation from people. If you do any khair, do it in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although, Islam teaches us that if someone does us any good, we should tell to him, Jazakallahu khair, may Allah bless you with good. Aisha radiallahu anha, whenever she would send food or anything for the needy, she would always send a slave girl to listen what the people say about her. Barakallahu feekum, may Allah bless you all. And then Aisha radiallahu anha would say, Wafiim barakallah, and may Allah bless them. She said, we return the greetings in a similar way and our reward remains with us. We do everything we can to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is cause number 6, to not expect appreciation from people. Cause number 7 is, we have to be kind to all. Be kind to everyone. Be kind to every human being, Muslim or non-Muslim. Be kind to every animal or any other animate thing. Don't you feel good when you save the life of a human being or an animal? That is a true happiness. And we know that a man was forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just because he quenched the thirst of a thirsty dog. So we should always be kind to everyone. We should be kind to all. Cause number 8 is, repel boredom with work. A Muslim should not feel I feel bored. I don't know what to do. I just want to kill my time. Have you heard these terms? We say, let us kill time. But by killing time, we are killing our own selves, as we consist of nothing but minutes and seconds. And a true Muslim will never be free, as it is mentioned in Surah Inshirah, chapter 94, verse 78. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. Therefore, when you're free, still labor hard. Shaykh al-Islam, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi's grandfather told to his son, "Oh my son, I cannot take my book with me to the toilet. So whenever I enter the toilet, read in a louder voice so that I can hear what you say." Those were our pious predecessors who knew the value of time. The Prophet poem says, in Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 8, hadith number 6412, there are two blessings that people lose, that are health and free time. So we should always utilize the free time in doing good deeds. As we know, we'll be questioned on the Day of Judgment about our free time. What are we going to say? I was watching a telly serial. I was watching a football match. No, my dear brothers and sisters, this is not the answer you're going to give. So you always utilize the free time in doing good deeds. Cause number 9 is to be content with Allah's Qadr. Be content with Allah's Qadr. Allah is not wronging us. Whatever happens, happens for our own good and because Allah loves us. He did not want you to leave your house and then suddenly the roof falls upon you and you become a shaheed. Don't you want shahada? Don't you want Jannah? They say they were innocent children. Children, Ibrahim alayhi salam will take care of them in Jannah. So that is a contentment with Allah's Qadr. And if any calamity strikes, we say, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. All praise be to Allah in every circumstance. Cause number 10 is, always know, Innamal usri yusra. With every distress, there is a leaf, there is light. There will be a light and there will be a leaf coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cause number 11 is, make lemon a sweet drink. When Abu Bakr radiallahu an and the Prophet peace be upon him were leaving from Medina, Suraqa bin Malik followed them, as he wanted the reward of 100 she camels, which was put on capturing Abu Bakr radiallahu an and the Prophet peace be upon him. Abu Bakr radiallahu an noticed him following them, so he informed the Prophet of Allah. The Prophet peace be upon him said, "No need to worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of us." And then, all of a sudden, Suraqa's horse slipped and fell on the rocky land. This happened thrice. Then the Prophet peace be upon him said, "Oh Suraqa, go back, as you will not be able to capture us. And I see the bracelet of the king of Persia in your possession." Just imagine, someone is wanted and he's promising the bracelet of the king of Persia. Ultimately, Muslims took over Persia and in the caliphate of Umar ibn al-Khattab, the bracelets were brought forth to Suraqa bin Malik. Imam Hanbal became the Imam of Ahlul Sunnah out of jail. Imam Salahuddin Ahmadullah Alay reduced 20 volumes of the Hanafi Mazhab when he was imprisoned in a well. So you make lemon a sweet drink. Cosmo 12 is, whenever you are in distress, call upon Allah Azza wa Jal by saying, "Ya Allah," and this will bring you a relief immediately. Cosmo 13 is, concentrate on your own sins and not the sins of others. We should always concentrate and focus on our own sins, as we have enough sins. So that is Cosmo 13. To concentrate on your own sins and not the sins of others. Cause number 14 is hoping for Allah's reward. Allah rewards immensely. And you know that if you offer 2 rakats fajr and then wait in a mosque and then you offer 2 rakats after sunrise, you get the sawab of 1 hajj and 1 umrah. So you see, you can do 1 hajj and umrah every day. So keeping this in mind, it brings you happiness. Cause number 15 is make the fruit and always leave the seed. For instance, there's an alim and he's very good. He's well learned. You take all the good qualities from him and leave all his shortcomings unto him and do not apply it. And if you want to search for someone who is perfect, I'm challenging you. There's not a single soul on this earth who's perfect. So that's cause number 15, to always make the fruit and leave the seed. Cause number 16 is, Iman is the most important thing of your life. If you have the Iman, my dear brothers and sisters, you have everything. But if you lose it, you have lost everything. So always maintain your Iman. This will bring you happiness. Cause number 17 is, always keep your tongue busy with the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always keep your tongue busy with the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, Allahumma inni zikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadati. Because that, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the food for the hearts. I would like to end my talk by quoting the verse that I mentioned in the beginning of my talk from Surah Fajr, chapter number 89, verse number 27 to 30. Ya ayyatuha nafsul mutmainna, O righteous soul, in complete rest and satisfaction. Irji'i ila rabbiki raziyatan marziya. Come back to thy Lord, willingly and willingly unto Him. Fadkhuli fi ibadi, and enter thou among my devotees. Wadkhuli jannati, and enter thou my heaven. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.